I've been running the vacuum ported catch can for a few weeks now. I took some more measurements and learned a few things, and I want to share those results with you. Let's take a look. What's happening, everybody? So up to this point, we've been through about 8 videos related to crankcase pressure, sumping, and all of those related topics. So if you want to catch up on any of those videos, there'll be a link to the playlist here and in the video description. And don't forget to check the video description for this video and all of my videos, because I always give you links to the different sections of the video so you can skip ahead if you want to, and also provide links to parts and tools that may be related to the current project, and also give you links to other videos that may be relevant. In my last video, I set up a vacuum ported catch can on the Softail Street Bob, and the point of that project was to combine a crankcase vent with an external breather mod and a vacuum source to maybe bring the best of all those worlds together in a crankcase venting solution. And if you didn't see that video, you can get to it here or from the link in the video description. I do recommend that you watch that video so that you'll have all the background information about this project. It will really help out as you look at the big picture and look at the results that I'm going to share today. And don't forget, like I said in the last video, this is experimental. I'm just testing some things out and passing along what I learned along the way and trying to share that information with you. My work with this project resulted in 2 solutions that are probably pretty viable for providing both crankcase ventilation and a source of vacuum for the crankcase while incorporating that into a catch can. The first of those options is using that throttle body vacuum port with some sort of a damper so that you can control that vacuum 8 or 9 inches at idle. It's just too much vacuum. The other option is tapping into the intake tube on your intake or tapping into the backing plate on your air cleaner, or depending on the configuration that you're using, somehow tying into the airflow that's already coming in to both vent those gases and potentially supply a source of vacuum. Let me pause just a second and say thanks for taking the time to check out this video. My name is Ron Chenal, and here on this channel I tackle projects large and small related to the bikes I ride, and I try to share as much information as possible along the way. So if that's the kind of content you're looking for, please be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and enable all notifications so you don't miss out whenever I post a new video. Now let's get back to those catch can results. I came up with a slightly better monitoring solution so I could get some more readings while I was on the road. I went and logged some miles with both of these configurations. So let's take a look at what I found. So I started with the solution that uses the throttle body vacuum port and a damper, because that's the way I had it configured from the last video. I had it dialed in to about 2 inches of vacuum at idle. At sustained highway speeds, it definitely produced a positive crankcase pressure, and I'm estimating about a 3 to 4 inch delta over the vacuum at idle versus the pressure at highway speeds. And as a reminder, the goal is to have either no pressure in the crankcase or some small amount of vacuum in the crankcase, which just helps things out. And knowing that, if I was to retain the current solution on my bike, I would definitely want to dial that in a little bit better to make sure that I didn't end up with positive crankcase pressure in the end after all this work and all these experiments and all these efforts to actually get rid of all that crankcase pressure. If you took the time to experiment with it, you could certainly fine-tune the throttle body solution, use different vacuum levels at idle, and figure out which of those settings was the best level to offset that pressure at highway speeds. But again, the question remains, how much vacuum is too much? How much vacuum is the right amount? And where is that line where there's too much vacuum in the crankcase and you start to get other problems like gasket leaks and other detrimental things? I then reconfigured it to the intake tube version of this solution and went out on the road to log some more miles and get some more readings. And from what I can tell, there was still additional pressure at highway speeds, but it was a much smaller variation in pressure compared to the throttle body ported solution with the damper. And I'm estimating maybe 1 inch of pressure difference between idle and highway speeds, maybe 1.5 inches, somewhere in that range. Now, was that caused by the ram air effect of air entering into that intake tube? Was it caused by the movement of the pistons, normal blow-by, or some combination of all those things? I'm really not sure, but I definitely like the smaller variation in pressure between idle and highway speeds with this particular version of the solution. So my best guess as to why there's a bigger difference in pressure between idle and highway speeds between those two solutions is that with the throttle body ported solution, there is a damper in that system. And so any excess pressure that builds up in the crankcase behind that damper, it really can't get out. It stays trapped in the crankcase. Whereas with the intake tube ported solution, any pressure that builds in the crankcase just has to get through that hose to get to the intake tube to reach atmospheric pressure and even things out. So what does all of this mean for this vacuum-ported catch can for venting the crankcase? Well, there are an awful lot of variables involved in this, even more if you use the throttle body solution, because you do have to put a damper in the line and figure out the right setting for that and make sure everything stays in balance. In contrast, the plain old original crankcase venting solution that I did way back when has basically no variables, and it has a check valve and a pod filter, and it's super simple. And the intake tube solution with this catch can is the closest to that plain old transmission top cover crankcase vent. So what's my decision after using this solution for a while and trying out the different variations? Well, I definitely prefer fewer variables. And because of that, I'm gonna switch back to the intake tube ported solution, because I just really don't wanna go back and forth and experiment with a bunch of different settings using that damper valve. And I'm probably gonna experiment with a check valve as well. At some point, I may just switch back to the plain old transmission top cover crankcase vent with the check valve and a pod filter because it works so well. Did I miss anything with the information that I've covered in this follow-up video? And do you have a vote as to which solution you prefer? And are you using a crankcase venting solution on your bike or a variation of this catch can solution? Drop in a comment and let me know. I'd love to hear about your project and hear how it's working and learn about your experiences. And don't hesitate to let me know if there are certain video topics you want me to cover in the future. And if you found this video informational or useful, please do hit that thumbs up button and share it with your friends. That's a big help for the channel. It means a lot to me. And it also tells YouTube that you appreciate the content. And if you're new here, please do consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell, and be sure to enable all notifications so you'll be alerted whenever I post a new video. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoy the ride. I'll see you next time.